Yes, welcome to a new episode on Academy of Accounting. This is me, Surendran Bedrupada, speaking to you. Today, we are going to see a new topic, that is operating leverage in financial management. Okay, operating leverage, problem number one. Before we are going to see a problem on operating leverage, yes, first of all, we have to discuss what is operating leverage. Operating leverage, it is nothing but the presence of a fixed cost in the cost structure. The presence of a fixed cost in the total cost structure. That means, what is the position of a fixed cost in the total cost? That determines your operating leverage. That means, if a fixed cost position, if fixed cost portion is very high in the cost structure, total cost, then your operating leverage may be very, very high. So, the operating leverage calculates, it measures the percentage change in EBIT, that means operating profit, percentage change in EBIT due to the percentage change in sales. When sales increases by 1%, profit increases by 4 or 5%. That may be because of the existence of a large amount of fixed cost in the cost structure. That is called favorable operating leverage. That is called favorable operating leverage because when 1% increase in sales results in 4% increase in EBIT, that is profit, then that is because of a high operating leverage, favorable operating leverage. And when 1% increase in sales results in 1 or 2% increase in EBIT, so it is a clear indication of existence of lower amount of fixed capital in your capital structure, sorry, cost structure. Then that stage can be called as unfavorable operating leverage. Unfavorable operating leverage. Therefore, operating leverage measures the change in EBIT or operating profit due to the change in sales. Operating leverage can be measured with the help of one formula. Operating leverage OL is equal to contribution divided by EBIT. Contribution divided by EBIT. Then how to calculate a contribution? Contribution is equal to sales minus variable cost. EBIT, contribution minus fixed cost is equal to EBIT. Contribution minus fixed cost is equal to EBIT. Then contribution divided by EBIT is equal to operating leverage. Degree of operating leverage can be calculated with the help of a formula, that is percentage change in EBIT divided by percentage change in EBIT divided by percentage change in sales. Wait, percentage change in EBS, percentage change in EBIT divided by percentage change in sales. Then how to calculate percentage change in EBIT? Percentage change in EBIT can be calculated with the help of a formula. Change divided by amount at the first level into 100. Change divided by amount at the first level. Change divided by amount at the first level into 100. Percentage change in sales can also be calculated with the help of that same formula. Change divided by amount at the first level into 100. So, degree of operating leverage is equal to percentage change in EBIT divided by percentage change in sales. Okay. So, operating leverage can be calculated through one problem, through the first problem. Let us see how to solve this problem. After reading the problem, we can go to the solution part. Okay. Yes, the problem. A firm sells 80,000 units of a product. The selling price per unit is rupees 8 and variable cost per unit is rupees 2. Fixed cost for the year amounts to rupees 330,000. Calculate operating leverage and degree of operating leverage if it sells 96,000 units and 64,000 units. See, 80,000 units, it is the existing production here again. 80,000 units. Selling price rupees 8. Variable cost rupees 2. Fixed cost in total is given 330,000. Operating leverage, you are required to calculate operating leverage if it is, if it sells 96,000 and 64,000. So,
Operating leverage can be calculated for three stages, three plans. The base level 80,000 rupees, 80,000 units. The first plan it is 96,000 and the second plan is 64,000. 80,000 units are the base side. 96,000 units like you calculate 64,000 units like you calculate cheyanam endana calculate endathu operating leverage calculate cheyanengil contribution venam ebit venam okay contribution divided by ebit is equal to operating leverage appo rendum calculate cheyan namukku ee moon level of output vachittu namukku calculate cheyam okay
yes welcome back ebit are various levels of sales EBIT, earnings before interest and tax at various levels of sales, that means profit at various levels of sales. Items, first base level 80,000 units. So details are given in your question with regard to 80,000 units. Okay, 96,000 units, you are asked to calculate EBIT at 96,000 units and also 64,000 units. So three plans are here, first 80,000 base level, second 96 and third 64,000 units. First, sales. Sales it is given. Sales rupees 8 per unit. 8 per unit. 80,000 into 8 that is equal to 6,40,000. 96,000 into 8 that is equal to 96,000 into rupees 8. 7,68,000. 7,68,000. 64,000 into 8 that is equal to 5,12,000. 5,12,000. Then less variable cost. Less variable cost. Variable cost is also given in your question as rupees 2. 2 per unit. 80,000 into 2, 1,60,000. 96,000 into 2, that is equal to 1,92,000. 1,92,000. 1,92,000. Yes, correct. 5,12,000, sorry, 64,000 into 2, that is equal to 1,28,000. So deduct variable cost from sales to obtain contribution. ₹4,80,000, 5,76,000. ₹3,84,000, 4,80,000, 5,76,000, and 3,84,000. So this is known as contribution. Contribution is equal to sales minus variable cost. Less fixed cost. Fixed cost. Fixed cost in total is given in your question as 3,30,000. 3,30,000 it is fixed, therefore, it is the same in all these three levels. 3,30,000. Deduct this amount from contribution to obtain EBIT. 4,80,000 minus 3,30,000, that is equal to 1,50,000. And here 5,76 minus 3,30,000 is equal to 2,46,000. 3,84,000 minus 3,30,000 is equal to 54,000. 54,000. This is known as EBIT, earnings before interest and tax, or operating profit. Operating profit. Okay, so it is obtained. இது கிட்டி கழிக்கணும் இனி அடுத்து நம்ம கால்குலேட் பண்ணது operating leverage ആണ്. Operating leverage. Operating leverage is equal to contribution divided by EBIT. Contribution divided by EBIT. Contribution 480,000 divided by 150,000. That is equal to contribution divided by EBIT is equal to 3.2. 3.2. Then 5,76,000 divided by 2,46,000, that's equal to 2.34. 2.34. And next 3,84,000 divided by 54,000 is equal to 7.1. 7.1. So this is operating leverage. And you are required to calculate one more, that is degree of operating leverage. Degree of operating leverage is equal to percentage change in EBIT divided by percentage change in sales. Therefore, first calculate percentage change in EBIT. Change in EBIT. And what is the formula for the calculation of this change in EBIT? Percentage change in EBIT is equal to change divided by amount at first level into 100. Change divided by amount at first level into 100. See, either you change one of the session calculated in that. ഈ ലെവലിൽ നിന്നും ഈ ലെവലിലേക്ക് മാറിക്കഴിഞ്ഞതിന് ശേഷം കാൽക്കുലേറ്റ് ചെയ്യുന്നതാണ്. അതുകൊണ്ട് ഈ ലെവലിൽ നമ്മൾ കാൽക്കുലേറ്റ് ചെയ്യേണ്ട ആവശ്യമില്ല, ബേസ് ലെവലിൽ കാൽക്കുലേറ്റ് ചെയ്യേണ്ട ആവശ്യമില്ല. ഇനി ചേഞ്ച് ഇ ബി ഐ ടി കാലത്തുള്ള ചേഞ്ച് നമ്മൾ കാൽക്കുലേറ്റ് ചെയ്യാൻ കൊടുക്കും. ഇ ബി ഐ ടി 1,52,46 ആവുന്നു. ചേഞ്ച് 1,50,000 ബിക്കംസ് 2,46,000. ദെർഫോർ 2,46,000 മൈനസ് 1,50,000 ഇസ് ഈക്വൽ ടു 96,000 ഡിവൈഡഡ് ബൈ എമൗണ്ട് അറ്റ് ഫസ്റ്റ് ലെവൽ 1,50,000. എമൗണ്ട് അറ്റ് ഫസ്റ്റ് ലെവൽ 1,50,000 into 100, that is equal to 64%. And here 1,50,000 becomes 54,000. 54,000 declining. Okay, idu 54,000 aayittu churungunu. Therefore difference is equal to -96,000 divided by amount at first level, same 1,50,000 into 100. Idu ninnana ivadike ettunnathu. Therefore that is equal to 64% again. 64%, but it is minus figure. -64%. Okay, so this is percentage change in EBIT. Next, percentage change in sales. Same formula. Percentage sales in, change in sales can be calculated change divided by amount of the first level. Then what is the change here? Sales are 6,40,768 agunu. 6,40,000 becomes 7,68,000. That is equal to change is equal to 7,68,000 minus 6,40,000 1,26,000. 1,28,000, okay. 1,28,000 divided by amount at first level 6,40,000. 6,40,000 into 100. That is equal to 20%. And in the second case, 6,40,000 becomes 5,12,000. So there also the difference is 1,28,000. 1,28,000, but it is a minus figure, okay. Minus 1,28,000 divided by 6,40,000. 6,40,000 into 100, that is equal to minus 20%. Therefore DOL, degree of operating leverage, is equal to percentage change in EBIT divided by percentage change in sales. Percentage change in EBIT is equal to 64%. Therefore 64% divided by 20%, and here also 64% divided by 20%, these two figures are negative minus figures. Okay, so here that is equal to DOL is equal to in the first case 3.2 and in the second case also 3.2. okay, 3.2%, here also 3.2%. so as these two items are minus figures, resultant figure is a positive figure, plus 3.2%. okay, so this is DOL, degree of operating leverage. See, this is the answer here. Percentage change in EBIT. So here ഇ ബി ഐ ടി 1,50 നിന്ന് 2,46 ആയിട്ട് മാറുമ്പോൾ ഇത് കൂടുമ്പോൾ 64% ആണ് വർദ്ധിച്ചത്. ഓക്കെ, 64% ഇറ്റ് ഇസ് ദി ഇൻക്രീസ് ഇൻ ഇ ബി ഐ ടി ലെവൽ. ആൻഡ് ഹിയർ ആൾസോ 64% മൈനസ്, ദാറ്റ് മീൻസ് ഡിക്രീസ് ഇൻ ഇ ബി ഐ ടി ലെവൽ. 20% ഇൻക്രീസ് ഇൻ സെയിൽസ്, 20% ഇൻക്രീസ് ഇൻ സെയിൽസ് എന്ന് വെച്ചാൽ, വെൻ സെയിൽസ് ഇൻക്രീസ് ബൈ 20%, ദാറ്റ് റിസൾട്ട്സ് ഇൻ 64% ഇൻക്രീസ് ഇൻ ഇ ബി ഐ ടി. When sales decrease by 20%, that results in minus 64% decline, decrease in EBIT. Sales 20% വർദ്ധിക്കുമ്പോൾ 64% EBIT വർദ്ധിക്കുക. Sales 20% കുറയുമ്പോൾ 64% EBIT കുറയുക എന്ന് വെച്ചാൽ വളരെയധികം നഷ്ടത്തിലേക്കാണ് പോകുന്നത്. ഇതെന്തുകൊണ്ടാണ്? ദിസ് ഇസ് ബിക്കോസ് ഓഫ് ദി എക്സിസ്റ്റൻസ് ഓഫ് ഫിക്സഡ് കോസ്റ്റ് ഇൻ ദി കോസ്റ്റ് സ്ട്രക്ചർ. ഈ ഫിക്സഡ് കോസ്റ്റ് നിൽക്കുന്നത് കൊണ്ടാണ് ഇത് സംഭവിക്കുന്നത്. നോക്കൂടെ, 4,50 ഉണ്ടാകുമ്പോൾ 3,30, 5,76 ഉണ്ടാകുമ്പോൾ 3,30, 3,54 ചുരുങ്ങുമ്പോഴും 3,30. സി, ഇതിന്റെ കോൺസ്റ്റന്റ് നാച്ചുറാണ് നമ്മുടെ ഇ ബി ഐ ടിയെ വളരെയധികം സ്വാധീനിക്കുന്നത്. നിങ്ങൾ സെയിൽസ് വർദ്ധിപ്പിക്കുമ്പോൾ വളരെയധികം പ്രോഫിറ്റ് ഉണ്ടാക്കാൻ പറ്റും, ബട്ട് സെയിൽസ് കുറയുമ്പോൾ അതിനനുസരിച്ച് നഷ്ടം, മീൻസ് പ്രോഫിറ്റിനകത്ത് വലിയൊരു നഷ്ടമുണ്ടാകും. സി, ഇതിന്റെ അർത്ഥം 3.2% മീൻസ് വെൻ 1% ഇൻക്രീസ് ഇൻ സെയിൽസ്, വെൻ സെയിൽസ് ഇൻക്രീസസ് ബൈ 1%, പ്രോഫിറ്റ് ഇൻക്രീസസ് ബൈ 3.2%. വെൻ സെയിൽസ് ഡിക്രീസസ് ബൈ 1%, പ്രോഫിറ്റ് ഡിക്രീസസ് ബൈ 3.2%. ഒരു ശതമാനം സെയിൽസ് വർദ്ധിക്കുമ്പോൾ 3.2% EBIT വർദ്ധിക്കുന്നു, പ്രോഫിറ്റ് വർദ്ധിക്കുന്നു. അതേസമയം 1% സെയിൽസ് കുറയുമ്പോൾ EBIT 3.2% കുറയുന്നു. So this is because of the existence of a fixed cost in the cost structure. Therefore, high fixed cost in the cost structure results in favorable financial, favorable operating leverage. Therefore, favorable operating leverage means the presence of a major portion of a fixed cost in the cost structure. Unfavorable operating leverage means a lower amount of fixed cost in the cost structure. That means major portion it is occupied by variable cost. Okay. So favorable operating leverage, it is always good for the concern. Okay, thank you.